Sam Stone came home to his wife and family after serving in the conflict overseas. And the time that he served has shattered all his nerves and left a little shrapnel in his knee. But the morphine eased the pain, and the grass grew around his brain and gave him all the confidence he lacked. With a purple heart and a monkey on his back, there's a hole in daddy's arm where all the money goes. And Jesus Christ died for nothing, I suppose. Little pitchers have big ears, don't stop to count the years. Sweet songs never last too long on broken radios. Sam Stone's welcome home, it didn't last too long. He went to work when he spent his last dime, and Sammy took to stealing when he got that empty feeling for $100 habit without overtime. And the gold rolled through his veins like 1,000 railroad trains, and eased his mind in the hours that he chose, while the kids ran around wearing other people's clothes. There's a hole in daddy's arm where all the money goes. And Jesus Christ died for nothing, I suppose. Little pitchers have big ears, don't stop to count the years. Sweet songs never last too long on broken radios. Sam Stone was alone when he popped his last balloon, climbing walls while sitting in a chair. Well, he played his last request while the room smelled just like death, with an overdose hovering in the air. But life had lost its fun, and there was nothing to be done but trade his house that he bought on a GI Bill for a flag-draped casket on a local hero's hill. There's a hole in daddy's arm where all the money goes. And Jesus Christ died for nothing, I suppose. The little pitchers have big ears, don't stop to count the years. Sweet songs never last too long on broken radios.
Thank you.
Right, here we are with John Prine. And now it's nice to see you, because you were supposed to be here last year, but what happened? You broke your elbow or something?
About a week before the festival. This sounds like a made-up story, but it's not. I was making some meatballs for my kids,
right,
and I had a bag of breadcrumbs, and I only used about a handful, so I didn't want to throw them away, so I thought I'd go outside and feed the birds, which I never do.
Right.
You know, it's the last thing I ever think of doing. I went out in the yard, and I tripped over this rock while I thought I was doing something nice for the birds,
yeah,
and fell and busted my arm in about three places. and so we had to cancel last year.
Right, yeah.
So we came back this year to make up for it.
And how was it? I mean, I really enjoyed it. I thought it was fantastic.
Oh, we had a great time. Yeah, really good crowd. The crowd was amazing.
I mean, you seem to know loads of the songs. I mean, there's like ripples of recognition every time you struck one up. I mean, that must be a fantastic feeling for a songwriter.
It is. To have them stand there and sing all the words to you, you know, it's really good.
Yeah. Your career really started almost by chance, didn't it? Because you just got up on an open mic spot. You were never planning to have a musical career, were you?
No, I was writing songs for mainly a hobby. Mm. And except for a few close friends, nobody knew that. I didn't tell any of my other friends I wrote songs. I just did it because I liked it. But I was sitting at an open mic at a folk club in 1970. And I was delivering mail at the time. And I had a couple of beers. I was with a couple of friends. And it was like anybody could get up that night.
Right.
You know, all you had to do was offer to volunteer to get up.
Yeah.
So they more or less talked me into it. My friends did. And I was kind of saying, boy, this is really bad, you know? And they said, well, if you think it's so bad, you get up. And I sang three of my songs, and they offered me a job.
Right.
You know, and I'd never been on a stage before in my life.
Tell us about duets, because you've done some singing with Iris here at the festival, with Iris DeMent and everything. I mean, you like duetting with female voices, don't you?
I really do. Like, down through the years, I've had different girls that have sang, you know, and stuff. And first time I ever sang with Iris, I just thought, man, I gotta make a record of it. Thanks for singing with me, Iris. She don't like her eggs all runny. She thinks that crossing her legs is funny. She looks down her nose at money. She gets it on like the Easter Bunny. She's my baby, I'm her honey. I'm never gonna let her go.
Well, he ain't got laid in a month of Sundays. I caught him once and he was sniffing my undies. He ain't real sharp, but he gets things done. Drinks his beer like it's oxygen. But he's my baby and I'm his honey. Never gonna let him go.
In spite of ourselves, we'll end up sitting on a rainbow. Against all odds, honey, we're the big door prize. And we're gonna spite our noses right off of our faces. Won't be nothing but big old hearts dancing in our eyes.
All my jokes are corny. Convict movies make her horny. She lies to catch her born scrambled eggs. Swears like a sailor when she shaves her legs. She takes a licking and keeps on ticking. I'm never gonna let her go.
Well, he's got more balls than a big brass monkey. He's a whacked out weirdo and a love bug junkie. Sly as a fox, crazy as a loon.
In spite of ourselves, we'll end up sitting on a rainbow. Against all odds, honey, we're the big door prize. And we're gonna spank our noses right off of our faces. There won't be nothing but big old hearts dancing in our eyes. There won't be nothing but big old hearts dancing in our eyes. In spite of ourselves.